Even though it looks like a random, bumpy mess, your brain is incredibly organized. It has its own version of Google Maps for navigating the world around it. But just how flexible are these maps to changes? Every sound you can hear or touch you can feel is because neurons in specific parts of your brain are firing. Our brains are organized topographically so that they can keep track of where things are happening. That means we can tell the difference between a touch on the arm or a touch on the face. By observing people's brains in different imaging machines, neuroscientists have largely mapped out touch and other sensations in the brain. They found touch signals from different parts of the body get sent to different areas of the brain, and from that, we've made somatotopic maps. The cool thing about these maps is that they maintain spatial relationships, meaning that receptors in my skin that sense touches to this part of my hand, and then this one, send connections to similarly neighboring parts of the brain. And you have these maps for each of your senses. In the case of touch, they've drawn out what's called a homunculus in the brain. Basically, there's a tiny man living inside your head. Okay, there's not. But the homunculus is an easy way to see which parts of the primary sensory cortex, right about here, sense different parts of the body. What you'll notice is size is not totally proportional. Bigger parts of the body don't necessarily get more sensory space in the brain. Instead, regions with more sensitivity seem to get more real estate in the sensory cortex. And this could be why our lips and fingertips are a lot more sensitive than our arms. They're represented as larger in the homunculus, meaning there are more neurons paying close attention to sensations coming from these regions. Diagrams like these make it seem like the map is inflexible, though. But that might not always be true. Let's say you lose a hand. Those sensory neurons don't just go dark. Researchers hypothesize that when a limb is lost, new connections may sprout into underused brain areas, or perhaps weaker connections that were already there can now take over. When looking at non-human primates with amputated limbs, researchers have seen touches to the lips light up regions of the brain corresponding to where the limb was. Which makes sense if they're using their mouths now to do tasks they would have done with their hands before. There are similar observations in adult humans too, though some argue it might depend on what the patient uses to compensate for the lost limbs. But a case study added some surprising new elements to the story. A young boy with both his hands amputated received a double hand transplant. Shortly after his transplant, he didn't have any touch sensations in his new fingertips, but in tests 7.5 months after the transplant, touches to the lip activated only the lip area of the sensory cortex, and touches to the fingertips produced unusually strong responses in the finger area of the cortex. Does this mean we can regrow and rewire massive parts of our brains within less than a year? Well, it's tempting to interpret things this way. There's a big debate in the field right now, and there's no solid answer yet. Patients with amputated limbs often report feeling their lost or phantom limbs, sometimes painfully. This probably means, then, that sensory neurons for the lost limbs aren't completely gone. So perhaps in this case of this boy who received the transplant, he didn't fully regrow new connections, but other connections were briefly allowed to take over. While it'll be helpful and interesting to know what's really going on here, the good news is that regardless, follow-ups 1.5 years after his transplant showed the boy can write, dress, and feed himself more independently than before. There are more neurons in your brain than there are websites on the internet, so what are you waiting for? Get firing on your very own website with domain.com. Domain.com is awesome, affordable, reliable, and has all the tools you need to build a new website. They can fulfill all your website needs. They offer .com and .net domain names and intuitive website builders. They have over 300 domain extensions to fit your needs, from .club to .space to .pizza. Take that first step in creating an identity online and visit domain.com. Thanks for watching. And talking body swaps, what about head transplants? Crystal tackles that heady topic here. And have you done the 2-point test before? Test out your sensory homunculus by having a friend poke you with 1 or 2 sharp pencils on the palm of your hand and your upper arm, and see how accurately you can guess how many they used. Thanks for watching.